In this video, I will show you how to use the MOSFET as a switch to switch a bigger load. Let's get started. We all know that a switch is used to open and close a contact on an electric circuit, and it is easy to establish on a breadboard. Here, I have connected a 5mm LED as a load, and even a bigger load like this bulb can be connected to the switch. But we cannot directly connect the bigger load with the Arduino since its pins are limited to 40mA at 5V. So here comes the need of the MOSFET. MOSFET are of two types, N-channel and P-channel. It is a 4-terminal device which has source, drain, gate and body. Basically, the body of the MOSFET is connected to the source, so making it a 3-terminal device like field effect transistor. For N-channel MOSFET, the source should be connected to ground, the drain to one end of the load where the another end is connected to the power supply or VCC, and the gate terminal to the positive voltage, in our case the microcontroller's digital output pin. For P-channel MOSFET, everything is an opposite. Source to supply voltage, drain to one end of the load, and a gate terminal with negative voltage or simply connected to ground. I have taken IRLZ44N N-channel MOSFET as an example. From the diagram, we will connect everything. After powering it up, we may see that the load is automatically turned on even without any connection between the gate terminal to the circuit. This is due to a static charge present on the gate, and even an electrostatic discharge from human body can trigger the MOSFET's gate. This effect can be minimized by connecting a 10 kilo ohm resistor as pull down between gate and ground. To turn on the MOSFET completely, we should provide a positive voltage to the gate, and this voltage may vary between MOSFET. Here, by varying the voltage, the MOSFET turns on completely when the gate input is about 2V. And this is known as threshold voltage or turn on voltage of the MOSFET. This parameter can be seen on the datasheet of the MOSFET. Now, for example, I will upload the blink program on the Arduino to turn on and off the digital pin 1 for 1 second. Now, by connecting the gate to the digital pin 1, we have successfully created a switch that can turn on and off a load. If you feel this video is helpful, show your support by like and sharing this video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel for more awesome electronic basics videos.